Hola, ¿qué tal? Bendecida tarde. Pues aquí de nuevo construyendo comunidad, building community, y desde aquí, desde el Río Rico, Arizona, Willow Nogales se encuentra presente para darles información sobre los programas que maneja el Condado de Santa Cruz, el Distrito Escolar, así como el programa que maneja Sodexo para la distribución de comida gratuita para los niños que están en la escuela, ¿verdad? Natalie, muy buenas tardes, ¿cómo se encuentra? Está Natalie y Rachel con nosotros y nos van un poquito de información sobre este programa. Natalie, bienvenida y gracias por estar aquí.
Muchas gracias, Santos. Yo soy Natalia Incha, yo soy la Food Service Marketing Manager para Sodexo en el distrito aquí de Santa Cruz, en Río Rico. ¿Y Rachel?
Hi, my name is Rachel Carroll. I'm the General Manager here with the Santa Cruz School District and
Perfecto, pues welcome. Muy bonito escucharlo, porque nos platican un poquito del programa y qué es lo que está llevando a cabo. Y ahorita, durante el spring break que van a tener, qué es lo que va a pasar con las familias y con los alimentos y lonches de los niños.
Pues antes ya tenemos un año con el programa de la comida para los estudiantes que están en casa. En Río Rico es poco diferente, tienen dos para que los papás puedan venir a recoger, dos lugares, que es aquí en Coatimundi y en Calabazas. Igual se manejan los bus routes, que es a la ruta de camión west y east. Entonces, ahorita ya cambió el horario. Antes hacían la ruta todos los días y los pickups de los papás todos los días, y ahora es nomás es lunes y recogen comida para lunes y martes, miércoles para miércoles, jueves, y viernes para viernes, sábado y domingo. Entonces, esta siguiente semana, aunque los estudiantes están de vacaciones, el distrito de Río Rico, Sodexo, va a estar abierto lunes, miércoles y viernes.
Natalie, pues qué bueno escuchar que también se les provee comida y alimentos para el fin de semana, porque a veces es necesario también, ¿verdad? Así que es. Qué bueno que se les da esa oportunidad.
Es una oportunidad para que los papás que trabajan, que no tengan recoger, recogen comida y ya no se mortifican.
Claro.
Pero, igual como acabamos de ver, los mercados de Sodexo vienen y recogen comida para sus nietos, hijos, nietos, gente que tiene niños que no pueda llegar aquí a Coatimundi o que pueda llegar a Calabaza.
Claro.
Entonces, igual, les vuelvo a recordar, lunes, martes y, digo, lunes, miércoles y viernes van a estar abiertos en la siguiente semana, así es que igual cuando vuelvan los estudiantes a la escuela van a seguir las cosas iguales. Las rutas de camión igual y Calabazas igual abierto de 11 a 1 y Coatimundi también de 11 a 1.
Perfecto. Sí, estamos cuenta de que ustedes están usando también el distanciamiento social y el uso de mascarillas para hacer esta entrega de comida, para mantenernos saludables. Aún estamos en pandemia, así que es muy importante continuar usando nuestras cubrebocas y así como mantener el distanciamiento social.
Así es.
And Rachel, so you're going to explain everything what Natalie says in English, so...
I might be a little shorter. Okay. So I've been a year and we're still here. This district, and we've been serving since the 16th of March. We've been serving when we were in hybrid. We were serving the students, but we've also been serving the community. We have an east route and a west route where we serve mobile meals on the buses, and we have two parent pickup sites, one here at Coatimundi and one at Calabazas. Next week, while it's spring break, we will still be open and serving. This program is open to children 18 years of age and younger. We serve on Wednesday, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And it's for the 7 days of meals that we serve. So Monday, we serve Monday for Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday for Thursday, and then Friday, those weekend meals. So we hope that next week that you'll know and you'll come and you'll see us. Weeks after, we will do this program at least
until the summer.
At least until the summer. So please, please, please come and take advantage of this. We really want our community to know that we're here and we're here to serve them.
Well, thank you so much for continue building community, and thank you for the service that you guys provide. It's very important, and it's always good to know that our kids, they are already 8 and they have something to eat, so we have peace of mind and we can continue with trying to bring extra food to the table and extra money that we need to continue surviving. So thank you for all the efforts and all the work that you guys do.
Thank you to our employees, because mm-hmm. yes, they're the front lines.
And today is Employee Appreciation Day. So after mm-hmm. we finish here, we've got a special lunch plan plus dessert for our employees back in the central kitchen.
Yes.
That's an amazing group of people that have been like our Sodexo family during this time.
That's great. Thank you for them too. And please let us know that. Thank you. From part of We Love Nogales and from part of the our community. We are very grateful and thank you so much. Now this is the let's go. I noticed that you guys bring an extra things to extra an event. Listen, let's go check the item sale that you got put it today.
And it's just something that we can keep providing for the community. Not just in Puerto Rico, but the whole community. So we started promoting community resources, and we are actually thinking on doing this once a month for sure, the farmers market. And throughout the summer, from here until the summer, we're gonna have different people come in and promote their resources for the community. Mostly, like, we're gonna post a community health center, we're gonna reach out to different organizations so they can come out and promote in a safe way, as you can see, a drive-through kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, just kind of get back to feeling a little normal, even if it's here outdoors.
That's
okay?
Good.
There's a lot of information out there.
That's great, Natalie, and just taking advantage of the beautiful background that you have in the behind
yes.
you.
So. It's always nice to walk from the center kitchen here and just sit for a while and
just
watch them out.
And we see the families that they are stopping by, and then I'll taking advantage to access to organic product, because all the time that you guys consume organic food, it's gonna be good for your health too. And also, it's another great opportunity for you guys to spend some of your money in local businesses, because for every dollar that you guys spend in a local businesses, we're gonna keep 43 cents circulating in our local economy. If the same as dollar you spend in a big box store, we only kept 13 cents. So one way to build community and continue growing as a community is to buying some of our stuff from local businesses. And thank you for inviting us. And we have Nogales del Mercado right now, and also we have Sara Rencha. She had a beautiful keychains and some other stuff that she made, so you will see it, and we're going to show you in a moment. Let's go and see it. So you
Rachel already did her shopping for the day.
Yes, I did my shopping for the day. I'm so happy. I have honey. I have so many things to make this evening. I'm thinking in French.
Uh-huh.
Zucchini are going to go on the grill.
You can say in French. So.
Darling,
okay.
Check
us.
De érico vert, de tomate, de pamplemousse.
Oh. Mm-hmm. I learned a new one.
No, it's just so wonderful, and I'm so excited that you're here. And my husband's going to be so excited because I'm going to be dancing in the kitchen. Taste this. So thank you for being here.
No, and thank you, Rachel, for let your neighbors know, so they came in and they were so happy also buying the beautiful products. They are Arizona growing stuff, and some of those products they are from Ixcaxita. It's a community in Nogales, in Tucson, I'm sorry, and they are refugees that they don't have the chance to work, so they. What they do, they collect they harvest all the fruits and vegetables that are growing in the surroundings in Tucson. So they take it to a commercial kitchen. So they process, they sell it, and also they distribute it and they sell those products. This is the way that they help to continue surviving in these times. So this is another of the stuff that we grow in our community garden. And Erica went to cut it this morning, so it's a fresh arugula, lettuce, mustard, and these beautiful rabanitos, radishes. So this is a great opportunity you come in to get it. This is the last one that we have. So if you don't have this chance to come here, we're going to be today from 3 to 6. Where's Eriquita?
At the farmer's market in Nogales downtown, which is in the parking lot between Courtyard and Fourth Street and Marlene.
And Morley Avenue. We're going to be there. Remember that we also accept dollars SNAP, Double Up Arizona. It's a program where you guys that have SNAP benefits, you can buy. And right now we don't have a limit. If you spend $100, we're gonna give you another $100, so we're gonna duplicate your money. And this is the program that we have right now. Because of the COVID-19, we don't have a limit. So you guys can spend any amount and the stuff from the local vendors, and we're gonna give you another amount, the same amount duplicated, so you can have, we can double up your money too. And right here is with Sara. Sara, it's always a pleasure to see you, to say hi, and to show the community the beautiful stuff that you create. And thank you, and I continue saying thank you for putting us in the map with this beautiful green cars.
Thank you. Hi, Shannon.
It's Shannon right there. Shannon, I saw her. say hi to Shannon. And you see these beautiful keychains. This is a beautiful earrings also that she made. These beautiful pictures too. So we're gonna be every Friday from 3 to 6 at the Nogales Rio Mercado Farmers Market in downtown Nogales. And thank you, Sara. And we're going back to the Sodexo girl to finish our chat and ask her what else they would like to add. Nadia, did you see what Natalie did? She also put a Papa Farmer's Market. she didn't want to get behind.
I will help her do one down in Nogales.
That's good. And we're more happy to help them too. So just invite us and we will do something good over there too.
I know she's watching. So.
See, I know. She's kind of hitting the floor with the left foot.
Yeah, she's eating my Rocky Road ice cream.
See,
it's also locally. Yes,
we'll
have to reach out to them. I have some good vendors for you,
Santos. That's good. Please contact us, and we're happy to work with them. Definitely. What else do you guys would like to add? Something that we didn't talk. Can we show the meal that you guys are doing right now? Yes. Let's go and see so they can come.
Hi,
Javier.
What do you have for the weekend? Tell us.
Sounds good. So far, so you almost done with this, or you have a lot of food to distribute yet? Okay, so it's a good opportunity for the families to come and pick up their food. So please, we're gonna be here till 1 p.m.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So probably you have like a half an hour, so hurry up and get and get the food for this weekend so you don't have to cook extra. Oh, you know what? The kids always hungry. And when they are home, there's always extra. So
of course, I have a nephew who's always hungry.
No,
it's always hungry. So he's like my child. So this is just an opportunity. In the past, we've actually made like food kits that the kids have assembled. So they have a pizza party. So we're trying to make everything that we can that is friendly to reading, everything like. Ready to eat just needs to be
prepared. That's great. And thank you for putting together and putting together in a safe way too.
Yeah.
We really appreciate it. Well, thank you so much. Thank you for the invitation and always is a pleasure to work with people that build community and also to find the ways to continue offering the services even in bad situation like we are living right now. Thank you very much.
Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bendecido día. We'll see you soon. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Déjame despedirme entonces. Bueno, pues me despido, un gusto saludarles y pues aquí andamos también de granjeros, es viernes de mercado, así que es un placer saludarles y decirles que nos esperamos en la tarde de 3 a 6 ahí en el lugar del mercado Farmers Market. Bendecido día, continúen usando el distanciamiento social y el uso de mascarillas, es muy importante que continuemos saludables. Así que vamos, esta es la forma en que las familias vienen a recoger su comida y se la llevan ya listo para servir. Nos vemos, gracias por su atención y les encargamos que distribuyan o que hagan share esta publicación para que más familias sepan y conozcan y puedan tomar ventaja de este servicio. Hasta luego, bonita tarde, síganse cuidando.